Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today returning for another episode of Rust Weekly, where you can get all the information you need on the latest and greatest Rust update. First, I'm going to hit you with all the new tweaks and changes in brief in the raid. The first wave of player versus player combat changes have hit this week with the addition of much clearer hit markers so you know what you're shooting and if you shot it. There's also a lot less sway when aiming down sight for your weapons, and for guns like the AK, the muzzle flash has been tweaked so that you can see what you're shooting while you're shooting. While we've taken a step towards Call of Duty in that regard, we're taking a step towards DayZ in allowing players to know when another player is holding Alt to look around. Bit rough around the edges for now, but we'll see that polished more in the future. The foundations for deployables, such as the Quarry and the Pump Jack, have undergone some big aesthetic and functional changes. The satellite dish now has a mysterious room, which it exists, and we have some new headgear, balaclava and the boonie hat, allowing you to fulfill your Django Unchained and fishing world dreams. There's new player idle animations when you're sitting around doing nothing, and finally some tweaks to the loot tables. That's it for this week, guys, in short, but now we're going to dive into a few more details and, of course, opinions in what we call the grind. Let's start by talking about the PvP changes, specifically the hit markers and bullet impacts. Hit markers are something that are debatable for a small portion of the population. The majority, I think, want them in the game for that PvP edge. Knowing when you hit somebody at long range is very important. And knowing if it's okay to charge, okay, I gotta hit it, he needs to bandage, it's time to move, it can give you some viable information. I'm kinda on the fence about hit markers, but I wouldn't be surprised to see a plugin in the future that lets server owners choose whether they want them enabled or disabled. If there is an option for servers by default, I haven't seen it. For me personally, I don't really mind them, I guess. I'll probably leave them enabled even if I was to get the option, but I do mind less sway of the iron sights when aiming down sights and strafing left and right. The reason for this is because you do strafe really fast, and while you're aiming now, you have to worry about zero deviation of that iron sight. So you can always have 100% accuracy while moving, which just seems a little bit weird. I'm not saying it needs to be exactly like, say, Counter-Strike Go, where it just completely opens up while you're strafing, but I do think that there needs to be a little bit of a tweak there in order to make it a bit more complicated. They're working on advanced hitboxes, which have also been tweaked as well, so that shooting things like hands and feet now do a lot more damage than they did before, but this is just phase one. They're gonna make it where, let's say you shoot somebody's hand who's holding a gun, the bullet can travel through their hand and go into their torso for additional damage. But that's not in the game yet. It is planned though. For now, they just made the extremities deal more damage when hit with bullets. It is a bit weird downing someone just by shooting them in the hands though. Don't get me wrong here, guys, I'm not saying I don't enjoy that style of gameplay, I'm just saying that they need a consistent goal to work towards. On the one hand, they don't want hit-scan weapons, which I'm in favor of that decision, so that's why we have bullet drop and velocities of ammunition of varying qualities, and we've also got this incoming penetration system for the bullets, but then we've got more arcadey style mechanics such as this strafing with no aiming deviation. They seem to be straddling the fence between wanting realism and wanting arcade faster gunplay. I don't know which is which, and I think they need to decide to have a clear and consistent message. As you're running around now, you can hear bullet impacts from greater distances, so when you're being shot at, it becomes a lot clearer where bullets are striking. It's better awareness is what it gives. And finally, muzzle flash has been rotated specifically on the AK so that while you're shooting, you'll be able to see your target in the distance. Previously, the muzzle flash was eclipsing your target and blocking your view. I think those are probably the most important changes in this update, just the moment-to-moment gunplay and combat, but there have been some important changes to the loot tables. For example, roadside armor is now rare, so when you're crafting your blueprint fragments and trying to get different tiers, it's in the rare tier now, whereas wood and bone armor are now common or uncommon drops, so that's going to dramatically change the early game combat as well. Less armor, faster dying. Leather gloves actually use leather now, which is a suggestion I saw on Reddit that I'm happy that was taken seriously. Pistol ammo is now common, some rad suit gear is now uncommon, which is going to make it easier to do rad town runs when radiation is added back, and the salvage sword is now going to become a lot more common. I kind of think that one should be uncommon, and the machete and some of the other weapons should be in the common tab. There's still some good tweaks in there, nonetheless. The rest of the additions this update are pretty succinct and easy to discuss. Deployables, for example, now having some protections when you're going out there and putting fuel in your pump jack or quarry, you have a few little tin walls that you can crouch down and hide behind, as well as some stairs that help you get up instead of just those little sloped incline. This is a good aesthetic change, and it provides a little bit of functionality as well. The satellite dish now has a room. It's a closet. I'm gonna lock you inside if you're bad and put you in timeout. I don't know what this is for. Maybe boxes spawn here. I went back a few times and never saw anything inside of it. Maybe you could just hide here and be a creep. Wait till you hear that clip-clop of somebody running up the stairs, pop out and shoot them in the face. It's a good idea. While you're hiding and wait, make sure you equip your brand new balaclava so that when you inevitably capture your prey and cut them up into tiny little pieces for animal fat and food, you make them poop their pants first. Not to be outdone, there's a second piece of headgear, the boonie hat. It's a shame that you can't combine hats, for example, not Team Fortress 2, but rather, say, metal face mask plus a hat on top of your head. One day we might have more slots and the ability to do that. But I do like the new additions, and of course more cosmetics is always better. Over time, we're eventually going to have a nice big collection. The ability to hold Alt and turn your head is now visible by other players, but it is terrifying. Watch as these people run through the forest looking every which way. You can't tell what they're looking at because it's not a one-to-one mimic. So if someone turns around and is looking directly behind them, it kind of just looks like they dug their chin into their neck. They're about to vomit all over the place. So I'd like to see some more polishing here because it is really bizarre, especially if you look straight up, you elongate your neck, and we're ready for some golden rings. Last but not least, the idle animations for certain weapons have been added, which just gives a little bit more atmosphere into the game world. They start with two different ones that I know of. There is one for just any type of default weapon that you have. They just kind of look around like they're really antsy, nervous, hyped up on something, and inspect their gun. And secondarily, we have one for the rocket launcher here, because holding that rocket launcher in this position has got to be really heavy, so they take a short little break, get their strength back, and then put it back up, ready to blast away. That's it for this week's update, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think down below, and what do you want to see from Rust next? Me, I'm still hoping for electricity. I'm just gonna keep hoping until I eventually get to put spotlights on top of my giant fortress prison and blast them all down on anyone who tries a nighttime raid me. Thank you for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I'll see you next time.